Have you ever wondered that it would be nice if we could use a single method for any different type of parameters and results instead of writing the same method again and again for different type of results? This is John from Java Code Geeks, and today I'm going to show you how to write clean and efficient code in Java by using generic classes and methods. Java generic classes and methods was introduced in JDK 5 to help programmers specify with a method declaration a set of related methods and respectively with a single class declaration a set of related types. Now, complementary to this video tutorial, you can find related articles and resources in the description below. Of course, you can visit Java Code Geeks to stay up to date with everything Java related. Now, before we continue, if you guys like these guides and videos, take a minute to subscribe, like and hit that notification bell just so you know when the next video is up. So, with no further ado, let's get started! The generic methods are those methods that are written with a single method declaration and can be called with arguments of different data types. The compiler will ensure the correctness of every type that it is used. So, the generic method syntax is as a normal method but with some peculiarities. These are that you must write the type parameter, for example here the letter T, as the return of the type of the method and can be declared later at the call of the method. Also, these methods can have different type parameters separated by commas at the method signatures. Last but not least, the type parameters can be bounded. This means that the method accepts a type and it's all subclasses or a type and it's all superclasses. To declare a type like that, the only thing we need to do is to write the extend keyword after the type followed by the upper bound that we want to use. So, let's see a programming example. At first, we declare a new class with a name generic method and then we declare a new generic method with a name example method that it has an array as parameter and it prints all the elements of an array. The type parameter of the method and the type of the array are symbolized with E because it refers to elements. After that, we write the main method and declare and we initialize with numbers and with characters three arrays, one integer, one double, and one with characters. Finally, we call the example method for each one of them. As we expected, the compiler understands which type need to use for every call and it prints the three arrays with no exception. As now for the bounded type parameters, we create again a new class with a name generic bounded methods and we write a new generic method with a name max and three parameters in which we compare which of these three is greater. As now for the T extends comparable, it means that the type parameters must support comparison with other instances of its own type via the comparable interface. Last but not least, we write the main method and we call the max method three times with integer, doubles and characters values and respectively, and we execute the program. As we can see from the results, the method returns the max value of every comparison with no error. Concerning about the generic class, the declaration is the same as a normal class declaration, except that the class name is followed by a type parameter section. As the generic methods, the type parameter section of a generic class can have one or more type parameters separated by commas and allows types such as integer, string, double, etc. These classes are also known as parameterized classes and of course we can follow the same syntax to create a generic interface. Let's see a programming example. At first we create a generic class with a name wallet and then we declare a generic variable with a name content. After that, we write two methods, the store method which set the object and the get method which return the object. After that, we create a normal class with a name example class in which we write the main method and two wallet objects, the euros and the ticket. As you can see, these two objects has different data types. For example, here the euro object has integer type and the ticket object has string type. Although we can use the same wallet class because it is a generic class. Finally, we store some items in the wallet with the store method and with the get method we print the items. As we expected, the compiler understands which type need to use for every call of the get method and it prints the integer number and the string at the right places. In conclusion, we can understand from the above examples that generic classes and methods help us with type safety because we can hold a single type of object in generics, Furthermore, casting is not required because there is no need to typecast the object. Also with code reuse, because we can write a method, an interface or a class once and use it with every type we want. And last but not least, at generics, we can implement algorithms that work with different type of objects, and at the same time, there are type safe too. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. We have some really cool stuff coming up. Bye!